Did Apple make the telephoto camera worse with the iPhone 17 Pro? This is what you need to know. It's not just a simple crop. A new telephoto camera for the Pro models was one of the key updates Apple unveiled for the iPhone 17 Pro and 17 Pro Max at its awe-dropping event. The 48-megapixel fusion camera with 4x zoom looks a lot better on paper than the 12-megapixel camera that came with Apple's last Pros. The iPhone 17 Pro and 17 Pro Max have the same cameras as last year's models. But one thing that hasn't gotten much attention is the optical zoom range of this new telephoto camera. According to Apple, the telephoto cameras in the iPhone 17 Pro models enable both 4x and 8x zoom. Those statements are valid, but there's more to it than that. The iPhone 16 Pro and 16 Pro Max had a 5x optical zoom with its telephoto camera, so what's going on? You might be thinking that Apple downgraded the telephoto camera for the iPhone 17 Pros, but it may depend on who you ask. Other businesses made similar steps, like how the S23 Ultra had a telephoto shooter with 10x optical zoom, only to see it downgraded to a 5x optical zoom with the S24 Ultra. I'll break down the details on the iPhone 17 Pro's 48-megapixel telephoto cameras, so you understand exactly how this new lens compares to the previous one. Before I delve into whether this 48-megapixel telephoto is a downgrade for the iPhone 17 Pros, it's worth looking at the phone's camera specs first. As you can see, there are two main differences this year with the iPhone 17 Pro cameras, the 48-megapixel telephoto and 18-megapixel selfie cams. Due of the new telephoto, Apple claims you're getting 5 optical zoom options with the iPhone 17 Pros, 0.5x, 1x, 2x, 4x, and 8x. This is one more than what you're provided with the iPhone 16 Pros. Another significant point to note here is how the aperture values, f-stops, for each camera are identical to last year, so the only relevant variation here should come out of that new 48-megapixel telephoto camera. I've seen numerous other phones tout zoom levels beyond their actual reported optical zoom capability. In recent years, though, there's been this argument over optical performance and optical quality performance. Apple's no new to utilizing this phrase, as it announced the iPhone 15 to feature 3 optical quality zoom levels despite not having a dedicated telephoto shooter. In order for the iPhone 15 and iPhone 16 to achieve its 2x optical quality zooms, they count on recording them with the 48-megapixel main camera, but at 24 megapixels, by isolating the capture to the middle of the sensor. And since the iPhone 15 natively snaps photographs at 24 megapixels out of the box, it's not inaccurate that Apple promises to have optical quality at 2x zoom. This is essentially the same principle with the iPhone 17 Pro and 17 Pro Max. Apple goes on to add that the new 4x optical zoom at 100mm offers a classic lens for portraiture, while the 8x optical zoom at 200mm, the longest ever on iPhone, provides longer reach and more creative choice. By default, the iPhone 17 Pros are set to capture at 24 megapixels, spanning 0.5x, 1x, 2x, and 4x. At 8x zoom and beyond, however, the resolution decreases down to 12 megapixels. But don't assume for a moment it's a downgrade, because you have to take in mind the camera sensor at play here. iPhone 17 Pro camera still captures greater detail. By going to a 4x optical zoom with the iPhone 17 Pros, Apple gives us that classic trade-off between the camera's sensor resolution and optical magnification. Yes, the 4x optical zoom of the iPhone 17 Pro is less than the 5x optical zoom of the iPhone 16 Pro, but this new 48-megapixel telephoto still captures more detail. Just remember that the iPhone 17 Pro uses the entire 48-megapixel camera sensor to snap photos at 4x zoom. You'll clearly get closer to a subject with the iPhone 16 Pro's 5x optical zoom camera, but you're getting 4 times more pixel information from the iPhone 17 Pro's 48-megapixel sensor at 4x zoom. This implies you could digitally crop the 4x photo and likely end up with a higher detailed image than the native 5x snap from the 12-megapixel camera. But what about at 8x zoom, when the capture goes down to 12 megapixels with the iPhone 17 Pro? Now this is fascinating, because it's leaning more on computational photography to attain that optical quality that Apple's known for. And no, it's more than simply a crop. In fact, Apple's Greg Jaws-Joswiak told us in our interview that it's a disservice to call it a crop, because it's way more than that. To put it another way, you're not merely capturing a static photo and then zooming in to obtain a specified zoom level. Instead, the magic comes from the sensor cropping technology that exploits its natural 4x optical telescopic lens to get physically closer to the subject. This results in the 4x lens projecting the image onto the 48-megapixel sensor, which then isolates the middle 12 megapixels of the 48-megapixel sensor to produce the 8x optical quality zoom. It's also worth noting out that you now receive a maximum digital zoom of 40x with the iPhone 17 Pros, against 25x with the iPhone 16 Pros. That's a tremendous difference. The iPhone 17 Pro's new telephoto camera also benefits from an upgraded photonic engine, Apple's computational photography engine, that enables the photo processing that happens in the background while you're capturing a photo, resulting in enhancements such as decreased noise, more preserved details, and better color accuracy. I'm convinced that the zoom performance will considerably increase with the iPhone 17 Pro, especially at the same magnification levels compared to the iPhone 16 Pro. On top of that, I'm anxious to test the iPhone zoom against some of the other greatest camera phones out now, like the Galaxy S25 Ultra and Pixel 10 Pro XL. The latter camera phone employs generative AI to enhance photographs at 10x zoom and beyond, so the iPhone 17 Pro and 17 Pro Max have its work cut out to top Google's zoom capabilities. Because Apple doesn't announce battery sizes for its phones, and because we haven't yet done our battery test on the iPhone 17 Pro Max, we don't know how long the phone will last on a charge. But all signals are very good. For instance, Apple says the iPhone 17 Max is excellent for up to 39 hours of video playback. That's a rise from 33 hours on the iPhone 16 Pro Max, signaling extremely strong that reports of a larger battery in the iPhone 17 Pro Max are accurate. You'd also assume the A19 Pro powering the iPhone 17 Pro Max manages power more effectively to boost battery life. That's potentially a huge thing, given the iPhone 17 Pro Max achieved the best result we've ever seen from an iPhone on our battery test. Surfing the web continuously, last year's Pro Max held out for more than 17 hours, putting it high on our top phone battery life list. There's a very high chance the iPhone 17 Pro Max pushes that mark even further. While we're talking about batteries, you can expect to charge up the one inside the iPhone 17 Pro Max faster. After years of being trapped at the same charging pace, Apple's iPhones now offer improved charging rates. Previously, the iPhone 16 Pro Max could get to a 50% charge after 30 minutes, according to Apple's data. That should take only 20 minutes using the iPhone 17 Pro Max. You'll pay more for a base model iPhone 17 Pro than you would have for an iPhone 16 Pro, albeit, obviously, you're getting more capacity in the newer phone. But the iPhone 17 Pro Max pricing isn't altering at all. Just like a year ago, $1,199 gets you a 256 gigs Pro Max, and with the Pro cost now only $100 less instead of $200, one could argue that the iPhone 17 Pro Max is a significantly better deal than previously. So, if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more exciting tech news and updates. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.